hours with her.
It's June 2nd.
Her heart rate, administering
about
her medication.
5:30 in the morning.
Comfortable.
We got to check through all the security.
In
we're about ready to get on our plane to go to Minneapolis. Then we'll catch a plane going to Saskatoon. Can't wait to get up there and go hunting with Bear Paw Outfitters.
Not tonight, Berta.
Pretty exciting.
Not.
The rut's going to be kicking in, so you never know what those big boys are going to do. But
it's months away.
And it doesn't really matter where the pizzaiolo comes from. The proof isn't the pizza.
All right, well, we're in Canada. Finally, just made it through customs and everything. All of our bags came. Seems like they're all in one piece, so that's good. We just got a rental car. We're going to load everything up, get out of here. We're going to head north. Brad says they've been having some pretty good luck, so hopefully we can continue with that and get lucky and get some nice bears. But, well, we're going to take the locks off these bows and just double check our strings and everything while we're here in town. We're going to be so far north, there's no place to get anything fixed up there, so we're going to double check them, make sure everything's good. Good. The sun has went down on our day of travel. We started this morning at 3:45. It's now 9:37 at night and it's getting dark. We're thinking we're pretty close, hoping we're within a few miles of Bear Paw here. I can't wait. We're going to start hunting tomorrow. Hopefully we'll get into camp and hear how those other guys did. Possibly, we hope that they had some good luck and maybe shot a bear or two tonight. So, anyways, we're getting stoked to be here and can't wait to try our hand and take down a big bear. Should be getting close about the mileage he told us. Right here, Bear Paw Outfitters. There we go, baby. Check it out.
Made it.
We're there, dude. We're there. They might actually be out with the other guys still.
Yeah.
Because I'm sure if those guys haven't killed bears, they're actually, they might actually be in camp or out in the bush. That's cool, they got a tree stand set up so you can practice shooting down. Well, this is awesome. Nice little setup they got here. About a half a dozen cabins. Got a nice setup back here where you can shoot your bow. Anyways, pretty dang nice. Let's go into the cabin here and show you around a little bit. This is where we'll be living for the next week or so. Well, got a nice setup here. Nice little cabin up in the middle of nowhere. Got some nice bunk beds, one for me, one for Dave over there. I'm pretty pumped. This looks pretty nice. A lot nicer than sleeping in a tent, I know that.
Yeah.
So, other guys are coming in. Let's go. They got one?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Yep, sure enough.
Practice shooting our bows. Just getting us dialed in to see, make sure our bows are on from the flight. And so let's check it out and see. Got our practice targets out about 20 yards. So.
we're looking at this bait that he's wanting to put us on tonight, trying to see how good of a bear this is. And pretty decent bear. Tony's making up some baits right now. He's gonna go out and bait some other stands, check the trail cameras on those and see if there's any monsters on those baits. If not, he's thinking he might stick us on this bait and see if this nice one comes in. But I don't know, what do you think, Davey?
I think if he comes in, I'm sticking him.
Well, I had to put in a special request when I knew Dave was gonna come on this trip. I said, you guys better find one, catch it, chain it to the tree for him. That way he might have a chance of killing a bear this trip. But this bear here, pretty funny. The chain's actually going down to the barrel holding it there, but the bear, it looks like it's going right to his back foot, so. Maybe it is, Dave. You won't know. We'll let him go right when we get in there. We'll have you blindfolded or something. And we'll just unhook the... We'll take the key and unlock him.
Yeah. Well, we just got to where the spot where we're getting ready to take a little four-wheeler ride into where the bait is. Cody's gonna go ahead and go in first and get all set up with his tree stand, the camera gear and all that, and then come back and get me, and we're gonna head in there and sit in there and see what happens.
Got pretty exciting there, last little bit of light. We had this little
little guy come in, watched him for a good half hour. He circled around. He just saw him. He just came in from our back end of us. Got Tony here picking us up. Scared him off. Pretty exciting. Too bad he's too small.
Well, it's about 10 o'clock on morning number 3. I'm going to head out with Tony on his daily baiting trip.
Look right over there. See that the barrel's been knocked over, so that's always a good sign for us. So we'll go in and rebait, check the game cam, see what we got coming.
Bear perfume.
So on to the next one. If you're ready, I'm ready.
What do you think?
Well, we came into where the big bear's been hitting. It's been probably about 4 or 5 days since he's been on a trail camera picture here. The barrel was knocked over, but Tony said there was 2 smaller bears on this bait also. So we're gonna keep going down the line, checking some trail cameras and just see if maybe he had moved down to a different bait or something. Well, just came into Sal's corner here. This is the area or the direction that big bear was headed as of a couple days ago. So we're hoping there's a couple sows here that are keeping him around.
That's a little sow. That's good. Well, I don't know. Yeah, yeah. Youngin, little single.
So every bait we've went to has been smoked. So that's pretty good luck, I'd say.
Wow, well, talking cameras.
Bears are here. Bear Paw Outfitters has the bears. We just gotta be in the right tree at the right time. So keep our fingers crossed. Hopefully tonight will be the night.
Well, it's the evening of day 3. We're at a different stand tonight. We just got in there and checked the camera from yesterday. We'd seen that big one that's been coming in for like the past couple days, so he came in last night at about 8:30, so we're hoping he comes in again tonight. Get pumped. Feel like today's the day. See what happens.
I don't know if you guys can really tell the detail of the landscape around here, but it is thick. I mean, we're literally gonna have to be super quiet, because if a bear comes, he's gonna step out and be on the bait. I don't know. There's a good chance we will not see him coming until he's right in bow range. So we'll just sit tight. It looks good because he's been here the last couple nights. Hopefully he'll show up again tonight. heavy right now, whether he's dead, but shot looking good. Hopefully he's dead. Well, we've got blood on the arrow. And, looks like it's a clean pass through, so.
Here he comes, just walk out
there. Yeah, okay. We gotta go out and meet Tony so he doesn't drive down here.
Looks you know, like
a shot, as soon as I shot him, he ran up the tree. And when he's in the tree, we could hear him like gurgling. You know, like it got along or something.
Yeah.
And then we just expected him to drop out of the tree. But he kind of climbed down and you could tell he was hurting. And I tried to shoot him again. Jerked it, stuck it right in the tree. But he.
I'm sorry. Well, that's good.
But
well, we're just helping Tony grab some bait. Then we're gonna go look for Dave's bear. We figure while we're down there, we're gonna check some trail cameras, rebait all the baits down on the north end of the hunting camp, and see what happens. Hopefully, we'll turn up Dave's bear and figure out where another good bear is, and we can get on that one tonight. So.
Well, we didn't have any trouble tracking down the tree that Dave killed, so we're going to try to drag it out.
I left a little landmark for him.
Good blood right here. Good blood right here. He said he came up and stood. Whatever broadhead you shot him with done a good job. They got a good blood trail there. I'd say this bear That's didn't go very far, boys. Blood.
Last place we saw him, Tony was standing right where you are.
Yeah, okay. Mm-hmm. He kind of disappeared.
Yeah, he kind of went to the left there, maybe. Yeah, it looked like.
Oh, he's right there.
He's right here.
He's right there. Yes! I'm pumped.
He didn't go.
I'm happy as can be. Pumped. Here with Bear Paw Outfitters. Brad Kramer and our guide, Tony Ash. Couldn't be happier right now.
Well, we just found Dave's bear. We're up here. Tony just took off to go bait a bait and check the trail camera. As you can see, looks like there's a storm coming in. Wind's starting to pick up pretty good. A lot of dark clouds rolling in. Looks like we might get rained on. Hopefully it doesn't rain enough that the bears aren't going to want to move. So, well, let's go check out and see if this bait got hit. Pretty fresh there.
Yeah. Root there. See that last picture, that's where he was laying.
Oh yeah. Okay. Yep.
No negative.
There he is.
sow hasn't came into heat yet because those cubs are, when she comes into heat, she'll kick those off because they were big enough they would kick off cubs. So that's a good sign that she might kick them off and come into heat in the next little while. Wow, that was pretty cool. Bear Paw Outfitters right there.
Well, guys, it's about 11 o'clock. We're gonna sneak up here, get in the stand. We left all of our stuff set up last night so we can be nice and quiet. We know that yesterday a bear came in between 10 and 2, so we're hoping to catch that bear coming in. Hopefully it'll be a big one. If not, it's gonna be a long set, but we're gonna sit here all the way till dark trying to get a bear killed today. So let's go get in the stand, see what happens. Yes, we just smoked a giant. We're up here with Bear Paw Outfitters in northern Saskatchewan. That big old bear just walked right into the bait, and I just put an arrow clean through it. We're gonna give it some time, get down, go find that big boy. Yes. Bear Paw Outfitters. Getting stoked outdoors. We're going to go look at a big bear. What do you think, brother?
I think we got a Lumilock glowing. I like that, so we need to go, let's go find out what you've done.
See how much blood's on it, huh?
Yeah.
Bear came walking right through here.
Oh, yeah?
Stopped about somewhere in this world, look back.
Yeah.
Like this.
Wow. I'd say that'd probably work, Cody, maybe. Lots of blood. Yeah.
Lots of hair.
I say we find this one pretty quick.
That's it laying right there, isn't it?
Dang sure is. I can trail this one up for you. Stand back and
you
let your guide find this one. Wow, dude. Look at the blood. Lordy.
Woo!
Man.
Look at this.
Oh yeah.
Bunch of hair and blood.
That bear didn't go 12 yards. Woo. Good bear, dude.
Yep. Thanks a lot, Tone.
You're welcome, Cody, anytime.
Appreciate it, man.
It's a booger.
Been a heck of a fun hunt up here with you guys.
I've enjoyed having you. We've had a good time. Maybe we'll take you a little bit of pike fishing tomorrow now that you tagged out. And fine bear, good shot, didn't go very far.
You think this is the one that you guys got trail camera pictures of?
I believe it was. The one we were looking at on the iPad I showed you is a nice bear coming in. I think the big old brown muzzle and stuff, I believe that's the rascal. Big old fat bear, big claws.
Amazing how quiet these things can be when they're sneaking in,
isn't
huh?
it?
It's
incredible.
If you want a heck of a fun bear hunt, places got some good bears like this, give Brad Kramer a call. Come up here and do some hunting with Bear Paw Outfitters. You know, one thing I can really say as we get up here and started hunting with these guys, that they have good quality bears. They care about their clients. And I can honestly say that I will come back up here and hunt with these guys. They're good people, and I hope to stay friends with them for a long time. And if you can say that about your outfitter, then you got a good one. So give Brad Kramer a call, come up here, they'll put you on a big bear, and hey, have a hunt of a lifetime.